Cheers.
Cheers.
Wow, that's real lager.
This is Cubs Pregame Live, presented by Fields Auto Group.
And the Cubs and the Rangers, game two of baseball 2019. Chicago will try to go to 2-0 after bludgeoning Texas on Thursday behind John Lester, Javi Baez, and Chris Bryant. And welcome to Cubs Pregame Live, presented by our great partners at Fields Auto Group. With David DeJesus and Doug Glanville, I'm David Kaplan. Cubs get off to a really good start. We are one step closer. The Pecota magic number is down to 78.
Come on. Whoever Pecota is doing that, that is some crazy number. That is a crazy number, thinking the Cubs are going to win only 78 games this season. Unbelievable.
I mean, that's exactly what you put up on the billboard every day. Yeah. You walk in, you see this number that you're only supposed to win 78 games. I mean, they just needed that little extra motivation, and 78 will certainly do that, especially when you won 95 last year and you felt like you underachieved.
Correct, and you were not getting your full complement of Chris Bryant. Basically nothing out of tonight's start of Yu Darvish, one win. Tyler Chatwood, wildly disappointing, so just didn't work. And your closer didn't even pitch much.
Yes, and there's a lot of question marks last year and at the end of the season. But Theo and his staff, they just trusted in their guys that they brought in, and they really went to their houses and talked to them, see what happened last season. It seemed like they fixed a lot of things.
Okay, so there was this big article that The Athletic put out the other day, said the changes that the Cubs made are multifold. Less fast food on the charter plane, less alcohol on the plane, more structured, scheduled batting practice. John Lester said, no, never. Everyone needs to be out there for this national anthem. Everyone needs to be out there for a team stretch. No more of this, we're the Cubs, we can show up, throw our talent out there, and we're going to win. Do you think that stuff plays that significant a role?
Well, they believe in that. And that's what's important. You're getting leaders on the team really verbalizing that this makes a difference. And, you know, John Lester has enough rings to back that up. And I think, you know, part of it is the change was cultural. That's the shift, right? We talk about coaching staff, the shift in leadership has happened. But they reinvested and doubled down on the talent. And that's great for a player. You say, okay, 95 wins is a good number, but we didn't achieve our goal. We still believe this is the core of players to be able to do that, and we're going to double down on these guys and do it. So you want to reward that as a player, but now the difference is just more cultural. Coaching, organization, obviously all the staff changes. I think that in and of itself is going to bring about change.
All right, Yu Darvish got one win last year, didn't pitch after May, said for some reason he felt pain. They finally went in, they said, yep, there's an injury there. They did surgery. And now he has looked great at spring training, sitting at 96, 97. He had back to that heavy breaking downward action. What do you expect?
No, I think it's more mental with Yu Darvish. Last season, he wasn't his self. The stress from moving from Texas to Chicago, where this is a big market now. Now the fans are going to be all over you. And then he didn't produce right away. And I think it was just his mental was all mixed up. In some of the games, he had a balk and threw the ball around. He couldn't get past the fifth inning most of his starts. So just to see him in spring training really talk it to the media, get rid of his interpreter, and really just show his different side that the Cubs fans did not see last year. It was really impressive. And then you talk about 96, hard slider, splitty. That's secondary. That's going to come if he can let it all go. It seems good right now.
Yeah, and I think for Darvish now, it's all upside, right? I mean, it couldn't have been any more disastrous than last season, right, from a health standpoint, performance standpoint. And now he's a piece. He's not the guy that they brought in saying, you got to be the ace, you're number one, and Lester and all that. No, it's now like come in and be like a good number four, and we're thrilled. You know, we're thrilled because now guys have learned, the other pitchers have learned that they can be that 1-2-3 combination. So it could be a pressure off him, and you're starting in Texas, which is beautiful because you get against your old team, a little extra spice in that like effort. So I see him in a better situation, and now he just has to stay healthy.
All right, it's almost time for you to get interactive with our show. Get your mobile, laptop, tablet ready. Go to NBCSportsChicago.com/vote. In a few minutes, we will bring you our live fan vote. Also, let's look at our great clips, clip of the week, starring the one and only El Mago.
Two down, nobody on for Javier Baez.
Let Javi do Javi, and I think good things happen.
Baez out into deep left, and it is gone! Cubs on the board!
Not surprised at all. That's Javi being Javi.
Number one for Javi.
Hey, where was that pitch you hit for the second home run?
Right where I wanted it.
Out into deep right, and it is gone! He's done it again on the very first pitch.
We got a front row seat every day, so it doesn't surprise any of us.
A two-homer, four RBI day for Baez.
Yes, a big day. It's time for our Miller Lite Cubs fan poll. To vote, visit NBC Sports Chicago. Again, you can weigh in there, and we'll get you the question in a moment. We go to Texas, and that's where we check in with the voices of the Chicago Cubs, the longtime broadcast team of Len and JD. Len, I'm going to start with you. You were around all spring training. You got to see a different Yu Darvish. This was not the guy the Cubs fans saw a year ago. What do you expect from him tonight? All right, we're having a technical difficulty with those guys, so hopefully we will reestablish with them. But, you know, I was going to ask them their thoughts on what we see from Yu Darvish. I thought you made a really good point. He's relaxed. Mm-hmm. He doesn't have his translator, and he even made a joke. He said, well, we can't afford the translator. So, you know, it was funny to see Yu Darvish cracking jokes because nobody in Chicago saw that.
No, I mean, you know, he had a lot of personality coming in. Texas, remember he joked about the fences are too close when he was in Texas. I mean, you want to see that other side to him and him being relaxed. That's important to perform. And now, as I mentioned, just not having that number one stuck to his back, he can come in and just sort of work his way back to that rhythm. And, you know, he has electric stuff. I mean, he was brought over because he was a multi-year all-star, the nasty movement. He had all the makings of a true Cy Young winner. And now he has to just sort of get back to that form.
Yep, he says he's healthy. All right, let's take a look at our Miller Lite Cubs fan poll question now. Visit NBCSportsChicago.com/vote. You don't need a special app. Just visit the website, whatever way you get there, and get interactive with David, Doug, and me. Today's question is, how many home runs will Javier Baez crack in 2019? 20-plus, 25-plus, like last year, 30-plus, maybe 35-plus? Or
320. I'm going to go 35 plus right now. He is just locked in at the plate. I think, like I said, now he's playing shortstop, so now he has something else to prove. He wants to be the best shortstop in the game. And I think that pressure, but that's not pressure to Javi. That's just me going out there and playing loose. It's just a different thing. And that those home runs yesterday prove that when he stays inside the ball, and he's focused on going to right field, his hands are so quick to pull the ball. But if he stays that way, like Doug said earlier, his game just takes off on different levels than most players in the game.
You know, I'm going to go with 30-plus just because I think he fell short with the 29. It drove him. He's like, oh, I got to get the 30. That's just that milestone number. So I'll go with 34. But the thing about Baez is, the numbers have been really incredible to see how line to line he can hit the ball. That's one thing. But he does it with power. And his highest slugging percentage is actually to right field. It's over 900. So he does damage when he goes the other way. He's not just sort of dunking it in there. He's driving the ball to opposite field. And that's something actually Chris Bryant really doesn't do as well. So he's power line to line. So he's dangerous, and what he does, he gets that outfielder deeper. They have to pinch the gaps, and all of a sudden, he has a whole field to work with, and that's what makes him so dangerous, and more so than hitters that are kind of, you know, center to their pull side. He's everywhere.
So he told a friend of mine, he said, I want to be the best Puerto Rican shortstop in the game, and then I want to be the best overall shortstop in the game. Of course, Lindor, who's now out with injury. Yeah.
Correa, too.
And Correa. Yeah. So you got three guys that you're batting, but he was referring to, hey, I want to be better than Lindor because everyone thinks he's the best shortstop. Yeah. So it's good to see that this guy's motivated by proving people wrong.
And he wants to be considered as a very consistent player. The goal in baseball is to be put up those numbers on the back of the baseball card.
Every year.
Every year. Just what Rizzo's doing. Rizzo has proven to be a consistent guy, a cog in the lineup. That's what Javi wants to do. And I like him batting fourth because he's going to get more fastballs now and hopefully Contreras behind him. That's why Contreras, in my mind, is a big piece of this season, because if Contreras is hitting, you're going to have to throw Javi more fastballs, keep it in the zone, then he's going to be able to be himself.
50% of the fans went 320.
I like it. I like that. I like it.
And I talked to Tim Wilkin. Tim was the Cubs scouting director when they drafted Javi Baez. And the story goes that Jason McLeod was then working for San Diego before he came to the Cubs. And he said, hey, who are you taking? We're at 10, you're at 9, so it doesn't matter. You can't trade draft picks in baseball. And he said, I'm taking a shortstop. He goes, good try, but Lindor won't be there when you pick at 9. He goes, I don't care if he is. I'm not taking him. And he said, you're leaving Lindor on the board for who? He said, Javi Baez. He's like, really? And Tim said, recently, again, he goes, listen to me. His bat reminds me of Gary Sheffield. Do you see it?
Oof. Oh, the whip. You know, you just think about the whip. And the difference with Sheffield is Sheffield seemed like as soon as the ball left the pitcher's hand, he knew ball strike. Javi's more aggressive in that regard. But the thing about Baez is, like, once he makes contact, it's damage. It's just, like, automatically damage. And that is what's so incredible about him, the line-to-line ability to really put power behind the ball. And you know the other weapons, by the way, the defense, the base running. We always kind of forget that offensively is only one aspect of this guy as a player. So Lindor, yes, he's put up, you know, 42 doubles, 38 home runs. I mean, this is Lindor, switch hitting shortstop. You know, incredible player. But Baez is really motivated to get there. And you know, who doesn't want a player that's motivated to be better after already having a great season last year?
All right, let's go to the lineup. This is what Joe Maddon's going to bring to home plate tonight. He will lead off with Ben Zobrist at second. Chris Bryant in left tonight. Anthony Rizzo in the three-hole at first. Javi will clean up again, play short. Five-hole hitter is Kyle Schwarber, and he'll DH. Wilson Contreras will catch. Jason Hayward's in right. David Bodie gets the start at third. He was at second the other day. And Albert Almora Jr. will get the start at center. And Schwarber in the lineup. He knew going into the series, I'm playing Saturday and I believe Sunday, and I'm not starting opening day. He seemed okay with it. On and off the record, everyone I've talked to who's covering the team said he was fine with it. Should he be mad?
No, he should not be mad. Zagunas had a really good spring. He deserved that start because he was hot. He had four homers. He was playing really good baseball. And he had the biggest hit of that baseball game yesterday. It gave him the lead after staying up the middle, got the base hit up the middle, and put the Cubs on top at that point, and then they just added on. But Schwarber is going to have a lot of at-bats coming up. The Braves have a righty-heavy, so the next four or five games, Schwarber is going to get his at-bats. And he got three at-bats opening day anyway. So in the AL, you're gonna get some more at-bats being a DH. You can pinch hit, and Joe loves to pinch hit. And, you know, right now, Schwarber's going to have a big season. Don't worry about it.
Well, when you get a double, then you feel a lot better. So he got in there and got his hit. And once again, you mentioned knowing when he's playing. That makes a big difference. So the fact that he's on board because he knows the plan on how he's going to be used. He knows when his starts are coming. You can prepare. And all that makes a big difference for your ability to just be focused and have a strategy when you go up there. He knows there's things he has to prove to get the batting average up, sort of be able to get the strikeouts down, all these different things. So once you're part of that team and you understand the larger goal, it's a lot easier to be on board with everything.
All right, it was also a big day at the dish for the other half of Rizzo, but in a much different way. Anthony Rizzo walked three times on opening day, becoming just the fifth Cub since 1908 to draw three walks on opening day. I saw guys, not only Riz, I saw guys grinding at bats like what we saw in 15 and 16 that we didn't see the last couple years.
Yes, and in the last couple years we saw first pitch swinging, yesterday, I mean 2 days ago, they were taking strike one. They made Mike Minor work, and it all came to fruition in the fourth and fifth inning. So the third time through, they were able to get to him. But all that work you do to just pile on pitches, next thing you started missing over the plate, that's when they started doing damage. And you want to get to that middle relief as soon as possible against the Texas Rangers, because those are a bunch of young guys that are just getting their feet wet in the big leagues, and they will miss over the plate as well.
You know, Rizzo's always embodied, as David said, the grind. He's always embodied that. He's a guy who even gets better behind in the count. He shortens up, he chokes up, he goes the other way. He uses the whole field line to line. He'll even take away a little power just to get contact. And that's Rizzo, and I think he's a model for other guys to start, wait a minute now. You know, because the tides are starting to shift trend-wise, and all the strikeouts that keep escalating, some of those teams with these high strikeouts are now not winning as much as they were 10 years ago. Those strikeouts are starting to become more negative. And so with Rizzo is a great example to follow of guys shortening up, putting the ball in play, and putting the pressure on the defense.
Yeah, I hate the game when it becomes one of three outcomes as usual. Yeah. Home run, strikeout, or walk. Yeah. I hate that. Yeah. I want to see balls in play.
And Almora, he saw Rizzo. He watched a lot of tape of Rizzo. Now he's choking up with two strikes, trying to put the ball in play more and not just swinging for the home run with two strikes. So that is starting to rub off on other guys as well.
All right. Cubs Pregame Live is presented by our great partners at the Fields Auto Group. Not a lot of great moments for you, Darvish, in 2018, but now healthy and ready to do what the Cubs signed him for, win baseball games. We'll hear from you after this break, and we'll ride shotgun with Johnny Lester.
I found out one day my son comes in the clubhouse and tells me that Chris Bryant's his favorite player. I love Chris, nothing against Chris, but I'm dad. It was one of those days I got slapped across the face, but at the same time, it was kind of cool, like, all right, you know, these guys don't really care.
Cubs Pregame Live is presented by Fields Auto Group. Fields matters because you matter. See Fields first, fieldsauto.com.
It's the new 2019 Mini Cooper Countryman SAV.
It's our largest Mini yet. Hello, I'm Dan Fields. I'm 6'5", and if I can drive it, you know it's bigger. But not just for me, also for my friends, as well as all their things.
Plus, not only is it bigger, the new Mini Cooper Countryman has a very cool price. Lease a new 2019 Mini Cooper Countryman All 4 for only $259 per month for 36 months at Mini of Chicago and Mini of Glencoe North Shore.
Fields matters because you matter.
I like it sweet.
I like it hot.
Red gravy.
Baptize it.
Make it cheesy.
Make it hurt.
North side.
South side.
There's one thing
both sides agree on.
Bona beef.
Bona, the original Italian beef. We cater, you party.
Spring is on, so it's time to get started. But first things first, call True Green for a healthy lawn guaranteed. Millions of homeowners like you trust us to give them a lawn they can live on. Start saving today. Get 50% off your first lawn application.
Anything else?
No, I'm all set.
Hi. Hi. I'll take one of those.
Hey, that's your laugh.
Booyah. That's my booyah. Booyah.
Maybe that was supposed to be your ticket.
Booyah!
Why let someone else scratch your ticket? Pick up your Illinois Lottery instant ticket and play today.
Boom!
Thank you.
I work hard and I want my money to work hard too. So I use my Freedom Unlimited card. Even when I'm spending, I'm earning 1.5% cash back on everything I buy.
Earn on my favorite soup. Ah, got it. Earning on that eclair. Don't touch it. Don't touch it yet. Let me get the big one. Nope.
This one?
Nope.
This one?
No. Let me get them all. I'm gonna get them all.
Just the basics. Can you double bag this right here? Earn 1.5% cash back on everything you buy with Freedom Unlimited. Can you also tell me what it is? Chase, make more of what's yours.
Let me go grab the keys to your new Hyundai.
All right.
Savings worth celebrating. Save big on Hyundai sedans and SUVs, including the Tucson, J.D. Power's high-strength small SUV in initial quality. The Hyundai Spring Fever Sales Event. The longer you look, the more there is to like.
Now lease the 2019 Tucson for just $189 a month, or get up to $2,500 in total savings. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
All right, Cubs and Rangers coming up 7:05. Yu Darvish, who's all healed up after surgery, says he's ready to go, and he will be on the hill against Edinson Volquez. All right, the guy that won Thursday's season opener, veteran Johnny Lester. Well, he was nice enough to take some time to do a ride-along with ace reporter Kelly Krull during spring training. Enjoy.
What people really don't know about me is I played soccer for like 14 or 15 years. I went to Europe twice and did that. And then obviously baseball. I played football in high school, and then baseball kind of picked me. I never realized how good I was, and then I started getting letters and calls from scouts, and just kind of picked me, and kind of took it from there.
So, wow, yeah, I had no idea. No offense, but you don't exactly fit the, like, soccer dude
You know, that was about 60 pounds ago, so, you know, I mean, the body has changed and morphed to more of a baseball body than a soccer body, so.
You enjoy being around this group? It certainly never looks like you enjoy them at all.
You know, it doesn't get old, you know, you only got so many more left, and I definitely try to, as I get older, I try to enjoy being around the guys a lot, you know, a lot more, and not worrying so much about, you know, the other stuff, because I know the other stuff, I'll be ready to go come, you know, April. The unique thing about sports is that there's a lot of turnover. So the unique thing about us is we've been together for so long. So you don't really see that much, but when you do bring in a Cole Hamels, or you bring in a, you know, Descalzo, or whoever it may be that year, you're adding a new personality, you're adding new life to the team. And I think that's what keeps everything balanced. I mean, what makes that special is obviously winning. You know, when you remember the winning seasons more than you remember the losing ones, and we've won. So everybody always goes back to that when things aren't going well, and realize that this group can do it and wants to do it, and we're all pulling in the same direction.
Cubs win 2-1.
I found out one day my son comes in the clubhouse and tells me that Chris Bryant's his favorite player. I love Chris, nothing against Chris, but you know, I'm dad, so that's really cool to me. And you know, taking him to school, and you know, kids have kind of figured it out, and it's just funny because he's like, "Dad, this kid wants me to bring one of your baseball cards home so you can sign it for his dad." And he's like, "Why does he want you to sign his card?" You know, you kind of finally realize, like, I'm just dad. I'm not, you know, this pitcher for the Cubs or whatever. So that was, you know, it was one of those days I got slapped across the face. But at the same time, it was kind of cool. Like, all right, you know, these guys don't really care. You know, I come home from a bad game, they don't care. They don't, you know, my middle kid is, he's always asking, "Dad, did the Cubbies win?" Like, "No, buddy, not tonight." Or, "Yeah, we won." And he kind of celebrates a little bit. So, yeah, it's fun to kind of see them grow up in this. And, you know, like, my kids still get excited. They get to see Chris Bryant or Riz, and these guys are just like my buddies. So it's pretty exciting.
All right. I love that guy. I've had a chance to interact with him since he signed here in the fall of 2014, and he's been the best free agent signing perhaps in the history of Chicago sports. I mean, Marian Hossa from the Hawks is obviously on that list. They won 3 cups with him. Johnny Lester has been earth every nickel they paid him.
I mean, he really has, and it shows that it's more than money, right? There's a quantitative value, but there's that qualitative, and he's brought so much stability to the Cubs, not only just the pitching staff, but the entire team responding to his leadership style, his focus, his consistency, his willingness to take the ball in those tough games. And he has the resume now, all the championships, the World Series titles, you know, being part of history twice in Boston and Chicago. So his resume is complete, and yet he still goes out there and still wants to be the best every single pitch. And that level of focus just rubs off. And clearly he's established himself as just an icon of Chicago sports.
And, you know, with John Lester, when you're a hitter and you're walking up to the plate, even with John Lester still right now throwing 88, 89 miles an hour, You're scared when you're facing him. You know that you're in for a dogfight because this guy is not going to give in. He is a guy that's going to attack, and wants to win baseball games. That's all he's there for, is to, when he's on the mound, to win that baseball game, and then he'll have some fun. But he is a guy that's going to lead by example, lead this team, and take this team where they want to go.
Yeah, it was great to listen to him at spring training. Had a chance to talk to him, and he said, look, I get that analytics is big in the game today. He goes, and I'm sure there is a place for analytics. But he said, I'm just telling you, when I go to the mound, all I want to do is give my team a chance to win. I don't care what my spin rate is. I don't care what my xFIP is. I'm just telling you, I'm out there, and if a guy gets 18 wins, he's doing something right.
There's nothing wrong with grinding. He is a grinder. He's grinded his whole career.
He's got an
career.
Old soul.
And, man, you got to love guys like that are just going to do what it takes to win ball games.
All right, time for our bona fide starting pitching matchup brought to you by the great people at Bona Beef. Yu Darvish has made 67 starts in Arlington, including the postseason. This will be his first as a member of the visiting squad. He is 2-0. 225 in spring training. He was really, really good. Edinson Volquez, who's now in the twilight of his career. Well, when this guy was healthy, he was rolling in Cincinnati. Should be an interesting matchup, Dougie.
Yeah, and what I'd like to see from the Cubs is that patience being applied to Volquez. Volquez has control problems. Sometimes that's where you get him. His stuff is electric. He's hard to square up, but he does have command issues at time. And if that shows up early on, you'll see the Cubs really roll today.
All right, you took some time to talk with us before Thursday's game, and he can't wait to be on that bump in Texas.
This stadium has a lot of history, and I'm so happy to be thrown here. Opening series.
Who are you looking forward to facing the most?
Elvis, Andrews, and Odor, Mazzara, Gallo.
The whole lineup.
Yeah, exactly.
You won't have any limitations. You can go as long as you're effective on Saturday. Is that safe to say?
Yeah, I can go more than 100 pitches, I think.
All right, here is the Rangers lineup against Darvish tonight. Shin-Soo Chu will get the start, and then Rougned Odor, Elvis Andrus, who hit the two-run bomb off John Lester the other day, Mazzara, Gallo, Cabrera, Guzman, and then Delino DeShields is in center. Hard to believe, I remember covering and interviewing his dad.
So how was his dad?
Huh?
How was his dad in interviews? Awesome.
Great. Good dude.
Yes.
Good dude. All right, Joe Maddon has noticed a difference in Yu Darvish so far this spring.
He was much more comfortable. He felt more comfortable being around us. It was reflected in his work. He was more at ease. He was still throwing the ball really well. His command was even better. Velocity was up. I think he physically felt better. And he also felt better about his environment. So I think both of those items contributed to him having a great spring. And I really, with good health, man, just keep him healthy. He's going to have a good season.
So we talked about it a little bit earlier, but it's good to hear it come from the manager that he's noticed differences in Yu Darvish, just more confidence.
Yeah, it's confidence with Yu Darvish. And today in the game, he's going to have to get back past this fifth inning. Last year, his ERA in the fifth inning, he had a 25 ERA, and a third of his runs he's given up last year were in the fifth inning. So once he gets to that fifth inning, it's going to be, all right, let me lock down and get through it and get back to who I am. And I see him coming out there, throwing that fastball, attacking with his fastball, and with that, and striking out guys with that wipeout slider.
And, you know, and that's a perfect example about this analytics question, right? The analytics may say in the fifth, you know, third time around, you got to do this matchup and get him out 4 2/3, but doesn't speak to the confidence Darvish can have if he can get through the fifth. And what's that? How do you quantify that? How do you quantify his ability to get over the hump and exercise the demons from last season? So I think it's going to be an interesting decision for the Cubs in terms of, you know, working those numbers and looking at the analytics sides of how to use their bullpen and what's best for Yu Darvish and then therefore the team across the season.
Okay, you guys both had to bat against really elite pitchers in your career. This is a guy who last summer said to me, I got like 7 different pitches I can use.
Yeah.
And when you come from Japan, a lot of them know the gyro ball and this ball.
Exactly.
They've got all these bizarre pitches. How do you prepare for that as a hitter, not knowing what whoa, what was that? I never saw that. And as a pitcher, how do you not get away from your best stuff because you want to use all your stuff?
Well, I can speak, you know, as a hitter for sure, the challenge is what do you eliminate? You got to figure out, because you're not going to have all seven pitches working that well. So at some point you're going to figure out, okay, his curveball is not as sharp, and then you try to focus on that. I remember Randy Johnson, if his fastball slider wasn't really working well, which was rare, he'd break out a curve and a splitter and all these other pitches that, like, now what? So I think you have to pay attention to that. And on the pitching side, he can get, and this does happen to Darvish at times, he gets a little lost in his repertoire. And so, oh, what am I throwing? And he's got to figure out what's really working well and what are the hitters adjusting to the best to try to stay one step ahead of them.
All right, time for our Joe Stonecrab What's at Stake. Handful of Cubs have some pretty good history against Edinson Volquez. Baez and Bryant stand out. You see the numbers right there. Hayward actually has 11 at-bats. Descalso with 14. Riz has faced him 12 times. Ben Zobrist has struggled.
And this guy, he's coming off Tommy John surgery, so it might not be that electric Edinson Volquez. But it's, you know, 2-for-4, 2-for-5. That's not a big sample size, but these guys just have to just go out there, work the count, try and get to that middle relief, because the middle relievers for the Texas Rangers, those guys are young and inexperienced.
All right. Deep in the heart of Texas, it's Tony Andracki. He has our Miller Lite game report. He's our Cubs insider at NBCSportsChicago.com. Tony, the Cubs offense allegedly broke in 2018. Chris Bryant said that Thursday was the best game in over a year for the Cubs, better than any game a year ago. So is the offense fixed?
Yeah, I think so. All it took is one game, right? Overreaction opening day. I mean, yeah, Bryant was joking, but really there were a lot of good signs all over that place. I mean, for Bryant, he hit that home run that he hit over 111 miles an hour. It was harder than any ball he hit in 2018, even before the shoulder injury. And yeah, all of these guys, I mean, they worked the opposing pitchers. They obviously drew a ton of walks. They used the opposite field. They went up the middle. They hit with power. They did everything you wanted to see from this offense. Really, they could not have done more on opening day.
In terms of the vibe in the Cubs clubhouse, Anthony Rizzo and Kyle Hendricks both said this week, it's different. I'm just telling you, it is different. Guys have a chip. They don't want to let this opportunity with all this great talent go by the boards without winning again. What have you noticed?
Yeah, it does look different. I mean, honestly, I don't want to just compare it to 2016, but it looks like they're on a similar type of mission. You know, it's all business, and they still have fun, you know, everything else. Of course, anytime you go into a baseball clubhouse, they're having fun. But there is a mission. There's a task at hand, and they want to go out and deliver this. It's not going to be like it has been in years past where guys, you know, just roll up at whatever time, because there's no rules in Madden's clubhouse. There are rules now, and they really want to abide by them. And a lot of these rules are stuff that players have come up with and everything themselves. So they do look like they have a chip on their shoulder, but they really more just seem on mission than anything else.
You wrote an excellent piece on our website on how the Cubs have become Javi Baez's team. Many people were projecting a regression, especially the analysts outside of our city. He finished second in the MVP voting. Early returns from game one indicate he's locked in, especially the way he finished spring training. Your thoughts?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, Javi, really, the sky is the limit, and they've been saying that forever, but he just went out and proved it. I thought that there might be a little bit of regression this year. I wasn't quite sure what to expect in terms of production on the field or numbers, but yeah, this is a guy that's actually becoming a vocal leader. He sees the game at such a different level, such a different speed than everybody else, and so defensively on the base paths, what opposing pitchers are trying to do to him, this is something that he can carry over and help the rest of his teammates with. But when we're talking about that on mission, that urgency and everything else, Javi has always had that, and now he's really become more confident. I mean, a year ago for 2018, he was hitting eighth opening day. Now he's their starting shortstop for, you know, the foreseeable future, maybe even longer. And then, yeah, he's a guy that's hitting cleanup behind Rizzo and Bryant now. So it's not just Brizzo. There's Baez adding to Brizzo here.
Hey, one more for you. Anthony Rizzo, I thought his approach at the plate the other day, Tony, exemplified what we saw in 15 and 16, that grinding, watch a lot of pitches, find a way to get on base. I thought Albert Almora's approach looks better at the plate. Is that something that they've talked about with their new hitting coach, Anthony Iaposi, and have the players spoken about it?
You know, the players haven't talked about it too much. Joe Maddon was pretty funny after opening day, though. He said that Rizzo was all excited because he got three walks, and that Rizzo's the only person that actually gets excited about three walks. But, I mean, really, it was good. There were a lot of borderline pitches that Anthony took, and he looks like he's seeing the ball really well. And this is a guy that when he's on his game, and we didn't really see that because of the poor start last year, but he's a guy that he's like Votto. He chokes up well with two strikes, which his hit was on opening day. But then he probably should have more walks than strikeouts this year if everything is going well. So for him, for all these other guys, yeah, the approach is they want to get back to that American League style lineup that they had in the beginning of last year, that they had in all of 2016, and they had for big parts of 2017. They really want to batter the opposing pitcher, and they made him throw 177 pitches the other day in 9 innings. That's what they want, 150-plus pitches every single time out from their opposition.
Tony, keep up the great work. Thanks a lot, bud.
Thanks, Cap.
All right, we have got to take a timeout. We have a whole lot more to do as we take you up to first pitch. Don't forget, we'll be back, the three of us, with the post-game show after the Cubs and the Rangers. Javier Baez wasn't the only superstar. We'll break down Chris Bryant's home run swing from opening day, and the guys will explain why it's much more than just a positive sign for the former MVP.
You're watching Cubs Baseball on NBC Sports Chicago, presented by OneTrust.
What is Blue Man Group? Hard to describe, easy to love. Get tickets now at blueman.com.
You know what's awesome about having the fastest, most reliable internet? All your kids' friends want to come over. You know what's not awesome about having the fastest, most reliable internet? All your kids' friends want to come over.
Do you like a chip?
Oh, honey, that's potpourri.
Oh, then do you want a potpourri?
No, thanks. I'm driving.
Get speed, coverage, and control with Xfinity XFi. Now that's simple, easy, awesome.
Get started with Xfinity Internet for $30 a month for 12 months. Plus, ask about enhanced network security with XFi Advantage. Click, call, or visit a store today.
Right now at Felco, good things come in threes. Save 33% on windows, siding, and doors.
Save 33% on windows. Save 33% on siding. And save 33% on doors. Feldco's energy-efficient products will also help lower your energy bills. Plus, no interest until 2020.
33% off and Sunday. Call now.
For quality windows, siding, and doors, call 866 for Feldco.
University of Chicago Medicine is advancing the forefront of health every day with innovations improving the lives of people with Crohn's disease, the most advanced care for complex pregnancies, and leading-edge cancer treatments that are shaping national standards. We're bringing research to reality and making the extraordinary possible so you can experience advanced care in everything we do. Welcome to the forefront.
Parents have a way of imagining the worst, especially when your easily distracted teenager has the car. At Subaru, we're taking on distracted driving with sensors that alert you when your eyes are off the road. The all-new Subaru Forester. The safest Forester ever.
Sports Talk Live, presented by the Chevy Silverado, weeknights at 6 on NBC Sports Chicago.
Bryant batting second in the Cubs' order, reported to spring training in full health. Left shoulder was the issue last year. This wasn't quite the same Chris Bryant. A drive the other way, well hit for Bryant, and it's going to go. It's 12-2.
How nice is that to see, Cubs fan? Chris Bryant back healthy and doing his thing.
All right, Doug and David are standing by to break down Chris Bryant's big home run swing from Thursday that got Cub fans very excited, gentlemen.
Yeah, when you think about Chris Bryant, you think about the power, but you notice in this particular at bat, he's using his base and playing to his strengths. His ability to drive the ball to the opposite field with authority is always a good sign for where you are in terms of how locked in you are.
And also, let me give you, last season he was barring, he was casting his back shoulder, and that zapped all of his power. So when he stays, keeps his arms close to his body and stays tight, he's one of the best hitters in the game, driving the ball the other way.
And so when you talk about the base, you look down here, you know, that where his feet are, you know, you'll notice, like, not a big stride. You don't think about these monster leg kicks sort of keeping that base. So you watch these feet here, you'll notice, like, where he ends up. So the first position, when he frees it here, right, not a large slide, a stride right there. You think about how he allowed the ball to get deep and then worked from his hands position at that point, and now he goes from that power zone.
And watch his back shoulder. His back shoulder here is dropping into the slot of the baseball. He wants to get on the path of the baseball. He wants his barrel to get on path with the baseball. So he's dropping, and you'll see in the next clip, his hips start turning, and he is explosive in his hip region when he's about to attack the baseball.
Right, so when you look at the next spot, right, another punt, boom, just rotates, and this is all power. Now watch this head position here, right? Yeah. You know, this is really critical right here. Head position is down, everything is staying through the ball, a little back foot there coming off, but that foot never changed. That front foot stayed locked.
And watch this back elbow right here, nice and tucked into his body, keeping it close, keeping that power from the ground connected through his hands.
Right, so then you talk about the launch, right, finishing, and, you know, still has that sort of tennis stroke coming through high.
Yeah,
but he's able to still get that backspin. We talked about earlier, the Tony Andracki mentioned the velocity was there. So watch this, all head position right here, all locked in. You know, so this is what you want, right? You want this ability to get those hands through, and now everything is focused right on that ball to get that backspin.
And this was a good pitch by the pitcher, down and away. And when Chris Bryant is at his best, he is shooting the ball the other way. But it shows you now that shoulder is back to being 100%, and he trusted to stay inside the ball and still have that big finish. And it's all about his head. I think keeping his head down. Look at this. The ball is already out of the picture. But this reminds me of Nolan Arenado. Nolan Arenado is a guy that loves to keep his head down through the ball. And that just gives that ball flight true path into the outfield. And that's beautiful because he's heads down and he's getting extension through the baseball.
Right. And then watch that front foot right here, right? Front foot stays closed, maintaining that power position. You know, this is great for kids at home, right?
Yeah.
You got to get that head position. You got to see what you hit. And of course, the power is right there. And right, and boy, he finishes.
And there was no squishing that bug.
Right.
There's no bug squish. All right, we're done with that.
So we're always paying attention with Chris Bryant. You know, that finish, we talked a lot. The shoulder was a question last year, but he seems very confident and comfortable with it. And he's known for that backhand. But what that backhand has, that backspin, that ball goes. It doesn't matter what ballpark you're in, it's going to leave it with that kind of power.
Exactly.
All right, time for our Amita Health injury report. And if you look at the injury report, Cubs are in a pretty good spot right now. You've got Brandon Morrow, who they knew coming in. He's on the 10-day injured list. Had off-season surgery. Should be back early May. And then Xavier Cedeño is dealing with some left wrist inflammation, so the lefty will still be rehabbing. But other than that, and those were not unexpected coming in, Cubs are in a pretty good spot. Much more exclusive content is coming your way on Cubs Pregame Live, presented by our great partners at the Fields Auto Group. 2018 was a tale of two seasons for Wilson Contreras. Coming up, Willie tells our Kelly Kroll exactly why the backstop stats took a tailspin in the second half.
I came out of my routine completely. And to be honest, I didn't deserve to have a good year last year. That's what I told myself, and I'm learning, like I said, I learned from it. I do that as inspiration, and now I'm here.
Cut, 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 cut.
Adam, let him out.
We'll pick this up tomorrow morning. That's a wrap, folks. Anything else?
No, I'm all set.
Hi. I'll take one of those.
Hey, that's your laugh.
Booyah. That's my booyah. Booyah.
Maybe that was supposed to be your ticket.
Booyah!
Why let someone else scratch your ticket? Pick up your Illinois Lottery instant ticket and play today.
Boom!
Thank you.
Do aliens exist?
Duh.
Of course we do. That's why I'm standing here in this cornfield, talking to you. Do great-looking, affordable glasses exist?
Duh.
Of course they do. On Zenni.com, with some as low as $6.95. See? You'll never take me alive, you mother...
Zenni.com. Seeing is believing.
Rover Velar. The Own the Adventure sales event is happening now. Land Rover, above and beyond.
And with great deals on all these Toyotas, you can make plans to go anywhere.
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 Woo! Hello?
Right now, you can get 0.9% APR financing for 60 months on a new 2019 Highlander. Or get $1,750 customer cash on a new Highlander. Hurry in today.
Ready, set, go get your Toyota today.
Toyota, let's go places.
Okay, got it. Got it. Cut.
Everybody leave the prop beer on the ground, please.
Hey. Oh, man. How's it going?
Oh, good.
Smile on the face of Wilson Contreras.
He made the All-Star team. I thought that was going to jettison, he's going to take off, he's going to be this guy. But for whatever reason, the offense never came to fruition, and he became really difficult on himself. He became very hard on himself, and I think he dragged himself down a bit.
This year is going to prove to be a big learning experience for him. You know, he kept saying, like, the game is teaching me. The game is teaching me, and some of the failure is teaching him too.
I just think he got in a bad rut and couldn't get out of it. The guy is incredible talent. An incredible talent. Strong, the way he throws, blocks the ball. There's so much good right there, man.
It was a disappointing year for Willie. There's no doubt about it. And when that happens to your catcher, it's a big deal. So we need him back.
We got to, again, extract it out of him, start over a little bit this year, try to build into this method that he doesn't become so emotional that he gets in his own way and permits this prodigious talent to take over.
Cubs are counting on a big rebound from Wilson Contreras in 2019. After starting the All-Star game last summer, his offensive numbers took a major nosedive. Our Kelly Krull sat down with Wilson in Mesa last month to discuss his disappointing 2018 campaign, and Wilson was very candid about what went wrong.
Coming into camp this year, what was your main objective?
Just have fun. Just come back to the camp, the best shape that I can get here. Looking forward to have a great season 2019.
You say have fun. Did you not have enough fun last year, you think?
No, to be honest, I did not. I think when the season was over, I reflect on my season. I think one of the main things that came to my mind was how much fun did I have last year, and it wasn't enough. So this year I'm gonna be having fun all around the ballpark, even on and off the field. I have to be myself. So have fun this season.
He made the All-Star team. I thought that was going to jettison, he's going to take off, he's going to be this guy. But for whatever reason, the offense never came to fruition, and he became really difficult on himself.
I used to get to the ballpark like I did in 2017, and I used to get on the elliptical or bike or stretching on lift. And to be honest, I just do like tubes, I don't know if you call tubes. I didn't lift. at all. I came out of my routine completely. And to be honest, I didn't deserve to have a good year last year. That's what I told myself, and I'm learning, like I said, I'm learning from it. I do that as inspiration, and now I'm here.
What else did you learn about yourself last year? And maybe in particular, the harder points of last season. It's always easy when it's going well, right?
Yeah. Everything is easy when it's going well, when you're not thinking too much, you're hitting homer, when you're not thinking too much, and you're hitting doubles with guys in scoring position. But I was too comfortable last year, to be honest. The thing kills me. I was way too comfortable. I talked to my family, my wife, about this. I didn't do my best on my routine, and because the season before, I hit 21 homers, and I just told myself, okay, if you hit 21 homers one year, you can do it again the next year. But don't worry. This game teach me that you have to keep working hard like you did the last year, and don't be too comfortable because you're gonna fail and fail and fail.
Have you always been a guy that can self-reflect and be that hard on yourself, or do you have others that you kind of turn to, like other coaches or other mentors? Because that's not an easy thing to turn and be like, I have to be better. I have to be better. With
no, this. That's myself. Okay. I know that I can be better.
You hold yourself that accountable.
Yes.
Okay, hats off to Kelly, because obviously Wilson has a very good, trusting relationship with her.
No doubt.
Because he was exceptionally honest. I didn't lift. I got out of my routine. Yep. Did that ever happen to you?
Well, I mean, it's a long season, and you think of the Tale of Two Cities. He's an all-star. You're like, oh, this is great. And then, like, sort of the bottom dropped out. And he hit 150 in September, and it became even clearer because of the struggles the team had. So there's times you have lapses, there's times you kind of have to refocus. Just happened at a time that was so critical for the Cubs and the level that they were trying to get to. And I think that's going to serve as a motivator for him for 2019.
I like how he held himself accountable. After a season, you really go back and you have to reflect. And he was just being honest. He put it out there on wax pretty much. But it's great to see that he became hungry. He's hungry in spring training. He swung the bat really well. And I'm hoping that this can continue through the season.
You know, he's a guy who he could change a game with his arm. Not many catchers have the ability to throw like him.
Oh, yeah.
He could change a game with his defense overall, and he could change a game with his passion because he gets everybody fired up, and then obviously with his bat. I was stunned that he had as bad a second half as he did.
Yeah, and it's also just learning to be a catcher at the major league level. I mean, that is a taxing position, just playing every day, going out there, managing staff. There's so much on your plate. So it needs an extra level of preparation, an extra level because of all that you're responsible for as a catcher. And so this is a big learning curve for him. And now with a new coaching staff, for the most part, it's his opportunity to really reset.
All right, we'll take one final timeout at Cubs pregame live presented by the Fields Auto Group. We'll be getting Doug and David's keys to the season opener here on NBC Sports Chicago. And our key performers, that guy, Yu Darvish, to the bump.
It's the new 2019 Mini Cooper Countryman SAV.
It's our largest Mini yet. Hello, I'm Dan Fields. I'm 6'5", and if I can drive it, you know it's bigger. But not just for me, also for my friends, as well as all their things.
Plus, not only is it bigger, the new Mini Cooper Countryman has a very cool price. Lease a new 2019 Mini Cooper Countryman All 4 for only $259 per month for 36 months at Mini of Chicago and Mini of Glencoe North Shore.
Fields matters because you matter.
I like it sweet.
I like it hot.
Red gravy.
Baptize it.
Make it cheesy.
Make it hurt.
North side.
South side.
There's one thing
both sides agree on.
Bona beef.
Bona, the original Italian beef. We cater. You party.
Whose idea was this?
Three new Nissans, two powerful Titans, one award-winning lineup.
Save big on all of it at Nissan Now. No brand received more J.D. Power Initial Quality Awards for cars and trucks than Nissan. Save big on Rogue with Safety Shield 360. Hurry in and experience why more people are loving Nissan now.
Lease Rogue with zero down and zero first month payment, or get 0% financing for up to 60 months on 14 models.
Get to Nissan now.
What is Blue Man Group? Hard to describe, easy to love. Get tickets now at blueman.com.
Spring is on, so it's time to get started. But first things first, call True Green for a healthy lawn, guaranteed. We'll do the dirty work so you don't have to. Download the True Green app today and make lawn care easy.
The mine, all mine. The woot woot. The brain bomb. These are just some of the symptoms brought on by big savings during the Hyundai Spring Fever sales event. And with 10 vehicles named IIHS top safety picks, it's proven to be quite contagious. That's a new one. The Hyundai Spring Fever sales event. The longer you look, the more there is to like.
Now lease the 2019 Elantra for $149 a month, or get up to $3,000 in total savings. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
All right, time for our Fields Auto Group keys to the season, since this is the first game of the season right here on NBC Sports Chicago. Double D.
All right, mine's what a relief. I fully expect this offense to have a big year, and the starting staff is one of the best in baseball. The only question mark right now is the bullpen. You know, with Brandon Morrow being out, and who knows when he's going to come back, it's going to be a mishmash of guys really out there. It's going to be Strope is going to be the closer. Can Carl Edwards come and get some big outs? Can Mike Montgomery be the lefty? Who's going to be the second lefty? There's a lot of question marks. So if they can get off to a hot start and get some confidence, it'll be key for that bullpen.
I'm going to say see you in September. You know, we're hearing all about September last season. That is a motivator. That's pinned up on the bulletin board about we cannot repeat what happened last season. You could see it in Wilson Contreras. They're focused, but they also have to look past that finish line and run through it. And September is going to be critical. I'm seeing this team competing all year, but September is really going to be the part that's the separator, because all the teams in the NL Central have made improvements. I mean, we saw Paul Goldschmidt with St. Louis. All these teams are better, so they really have to run through it. So September is that motivator and going to be critical for this season's success.
All right, time for our key performers. I get to go first. I'm going Anthony Rizzo, locked in at the plate. I think he has a big night.
I need to get off to a big start. You won last year, so I need to come back strong, and I'm going to go with that guy, Javi Baez.
I have to go off the radar just this one time. Go over to the pitcher, Yu Darvish. You know, Yu Darvish is so important. I see this as a time that you got to give the pitcher some love right now, and I see Yu Darvish having a big game.
Like it.
Yeah, he goes out and throws well. Yeah. Look, I think he'll be the biggest story in Chicago baseball this weekend. If he's good, or if, God forbid, he's bad,
right,
people are going to be talking about it.
No doubt.
All right, thank you for watching Cubs Pregame Live presented by the Fields Auto Group. Don't forget, we'll be back with the postgame show immediately following the Cubs and the Rangers. Enjoy the game, everybody.
Welcome aboard Cub Line Train 2019. This is second. Transfer to the dugout. At second, doors closing. Everybody in. Opening day is next.
Hello world, here's the dance that we're doing.
Come on, get healthy.
Put your heart into getting out and moving.
To keep us healthy.
Don't miss a beat. With the region's largest heart program, Advocate connects you to the highest quality care. Let's make healthy happen.
Share in a moment gets everybody cruising.
Come on, get healthy. Come on, get healthy.
Show me the crown. Show me homecoming. Baby sloth videos on YouTube.
Amy, do you mind giving someone else a turn?
Oh, yeah, I've made myself a little comfortable here.
I got a pizza for Amy.
Yes, that's me.
Xfinity lets you search Netflix, Prime Video, and YouTube with the sound of your voice.
And I don't have my wallet, so...
That's simple, easy, awesome. Learn more about streaming on Xfinity X1 or get started with Xfinity Internet and TV for $50 a month for 12 months. Click, call, or visit a store today.
Your favorite restaurants now deliver with DoorDash. It doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter what you're hungry for. It doesn't even matter how many you are. Restaurants come to you. Delicious at your door. Download DoorDash. First order, no delivery fee.
Winning teams need rookies and veterans. Take Binnie's. Harold just turned 97 and has been on the job since the 1960s. Rookie Nate is in his 20s. Both are on the Binnie's team, here to help you celebrate the best times of your life.
I'll tweet that.
Is it true Cricket has iPhone XR?
With the amazing liquid retina display.
Is it true that you wear a wig?
Could a wig do this?
Welcome aboard Cub Line Train 2019. This is Lester. Please sit down. Please sit down. Please sit down. Everybody in. Opening day is next.
Cubs baseball is back. It's a new season for the Northsiders. The NL Central figures to be highly competitive this year. How will it all play out? The championship core is ready. Watch and stream NBC Sports Chicago on the My Teams app by NBC Sports all season. Week is presented by TD Ameritrade. It is a cool and windy evening here at Globe Life Park in Arlington. The Cubs and the Rangers, game two of 162. The Cubs a 12-4 winner on opening day Thursday. Welcome to Cubs baseball on NBC Sports Chicago. Jim Deshays and Len Casper. The headline tonight is the return of Yu Darvish in more ways than one.
All right, coming back home to Texas where he was an all-star four different times and a return to the Cubs rotation. He has not made a start since May of last year, made just eight starts total. Had a very good spring, was throwing the ball well, had a little blister issue towards the end of spring training through a bullpen session Thursday, came out of that feeling well, all systems go, and it seems like it'd be a really big plus to get Darvish off to a good start this year.
Also a return for Edinson Volquez. He's back with the Rangers. This will be his first outing since mid-2017, coming off Tommy John surgery. What a big day it was for Javier Baez. El Mago hit two homers in the Cubs' 12-4 win in the opener. We'll have the lineups, the first pitch, and all the action. Middle game of the series is next.
Series tractor, because changing your attachments, whether it's for this job, or even this job, should be as easy as.
What about this?
Changing your plans. Nothing runs like a deer.
Yeah.
Run with us. Search John Deere 1 Series for more. Get your 1 Series for just $99 a month at your John Deere dealer.
Hello, world. Here's the dance that we're doing.
Come on, get healthy.
Put your heart into getting out and moving.
To keep us healthy.
Don't miss a beat. With the region's largest heart program, Advocate connects you to the highest quality care. Let's make healthy happen.
Sharing a moment gets everybody cruising.
Come on, get healthy.
Come on, get healthy.
Your favorite restaurants now deliver with DoorDash. It doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter what you're hungry for. It doesn't even matter how many you are. Restaurants come to you. Delicious at your door. Download DoorDash. First order, no delivery fee.
Baseball on NBC Sports Chicago is brought to you in part by Lexus, who encourages you to experience amazing. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, through it all. Ford, who invites you to go further in their fuel-efficient vehicles. Check out our entire lineup at your local Ford store or buyfordnow.com. Menards, save big money at Menards. And by Southwest Airlines, low fares, no hidden fees. That's transparency.
Cool overcast night here in Arlington. It's about 50, 51 degrees as we get this thing started. And let's dig into the Cubs Southwest starting lineup. 12 runs in the opener. Ben Zobrist will lead it off. He'll play second base. Bryant, Rizzo, and Baez, 2-3-4. Note Chris Bryant playing left field. Kyle Schwarber will be the DH, getting his first start of the year. Wilson Contreras catches and hits sixth. And 7-8-9, it's Hayward, Bodie, and Almora.
Rangers defensively, and it's brought to you by the Fields Auto Group. They're in red today, and they line up this way. Joey Gallo plays left, Delino DeShield center. Nomar Mazara is in right. The veteran Cabrera at third base. Andrus has anchored the shortstop position for a number of years here. Odor Guzman on the right side of the infield. Isaiah Kiner-Falefa, he's an interesting story. He's pretty new to the catching position. He's behind the plate, and the Lexus Experience Amazing starting pitcher is the veteran right-hander Edinson Volquez. Did not pitch last year as he was recovering from his second Tommy John surgery. Had one way back in 09 as well. So last pitch in the big leagues with the Fish in 2017.
So away we go. Volquez to Zobrist to get us started. Ball one. The leadoff man is presented by Binney's Beverage Depot. If Zobrist gets a hit here, Binney's will donate $100 to the Greater Chicago Food Depository. Ooh. Inside corner, says Brian Onora. One and one the count. Those first two numbers, average and OBP, led the Cubs last year. Oh, look out. Broken bat, roller foul.
It's gonna be like Zoe's got those hands pulled in a little closer, a little tucked more than he normally does. A cool evening here in the Metroplex. I was talking with some of the locals here, and they said sometimes the wind here, and we talked about this the other day, can be a little deceiving. It looks like it's blowing in one direction, but it's swirling. And oftentimes when it's coming out of the north, it really doesn't affect play all that much.
They generally have dodged bad weather around the big leagues to start the season, although there was a postponement today. Pirates and Reds. Zobrist in the air left center. And a little stumble, but a grab by DeShields. There is Brian Onora. He started in the big leagues as an American League umpire in 1992. He'll call balls and strikes. Hoy Ripperger, or Ripperberger as J.D. calls him, and Kellogg on the bases. Bryant walked and homered on Thursday makes his 85th career start in the outfield. You mentioned Volquez, two-time Tommy John survivor. And a lot of times guys come back from that operation and they throw harder than they did previously. He was hitting 97 in spring training.
Yeah, 93, 94 here tonight. There's some speculation that the gun was a little hot out in Arizona, but if he could sit 93, 94, that's Volquez at his best. He likes to sink the fastball. He's always had a plus changeup and pretty good curveball too. Over the course of his career, he typically works a pretty high walk rate.
Yanked in the left, fair ball for Bryant, and he'll make his way towards second. And he's in with a double.
Cubs took 8 walks in the ball game on Thursday. They have 13 3-ball counts, and this is what they do so well. Patient, get into a hitter's count, and then put a good swing on it. That's exactly what Bryant does here. This two-seamer trying to move in on him. And he says, not so fast, Mr. Volquez. Barrels it up. One out double.
Rizzo's offensive afternoon a bit overshadowed by his teammates, but he reached base 4 times. 3 times on walks.
That's what makes Anthony so special as a hitter. He's a slugger. Who's also pesky. He makes you work. He'll take his walks. When you come in, he'll do damage. And there you see the shift being employed.
StatCast AI is powered by AWS. The kick and the pitch. 2 balls, no strikes. So Volquez hasn't pitched in a big league game since he was a Miami Marlin. 2 seasons ago. First appearance as a Texas Ranger since 2007. Three balls, no strikes, and guess who's on deck?
The Rangers signed Volquez in the offseason prior to last year to a 2-year deal, and he rehabbed pretty much all year at their spring training facility with an eye towards making this comeback this year. And he's been really good against the Cubs laundry. I mean, the faces have changed a lot over the years. Most of the guys in this current Cub team do not have much of a history with him, but something about the Cub blue brings out the best in Volquez.
Right down Main Street, 3-1. Small chance of rain, but what the forecast looks like is it will come after midnight, if it does at all. And we'll have a cool afternoon for the finale tomorrow as well. Rizzo pitch to hit.
Got behind Brian, paid a price, got behind Rizzo, and got away with one there.
Anthony, 9 homers from 200. All of his homers but one hit as a Chicago Cub. Chokes up with 2 strikes. And he walks for the 4th time in the series.
Batting 4th, the shortstop, number 9, Javier Baez.
Javi, the 7th Cub since 1908 to hit at least 2 home runs on opening day. The last was Corey Patterson in 2003. 2 on, 1 out, just getting started. Swing and a miss.
I First home run the other day was on an 0-2 breaking ball that stayed on the plate. That's a big mistake. When you go soft on Baez, like a lot of hitters, if you're soft in the zone with two strikes, you're asking for trouble.
Out into left center. Cubs will grab the early lead as Bryant scores. And Baez will stick with a single. It's 1-0 here in the first.
Listen to these fans. There are a ton of Cub fans here this evening, and they're enjoying this top half of the first. Comes back with the changeup, and it's not a real bad pitch, but look at Javi stay in the zone with that swing. Out on the front foot, it stays long through the strike zone and delivers the solid single. First baseman moves into cutoff position. That allows Javi to take that real wide turn around first.
A run in, runners at the corners, and Kyle Schwarber, the DH. First start of the series, 1-for-3 off the bench, base hit, 2-0. Rizzo scores, Baez on his way to third.
This is kind of fun, isn't it? Schwarber normally very patient, but he got something to his liking early and took advantage. Good time to be aggressive with a man in scoring position. That's an area where Kyle struggled last year.
Julio Rangel with an early mound visit. Rangers bullpen should be fine after the off day, but they had to use 7 pitchers in the opener on Thursday. There's their new manager, Chris Woodward. Still looking for his first major league win as the Rangers skipper.
Good story in the local paper today about the impact that Brian Butterfield had on Woodward in his career. This was a young player with the Blue Jays, and Butter really took him under his wing and basically convinced him that he deserved to be in the big leagues.
So it's Wilson Contreras still first and third, a 2-0 lead before Yu Darvish throws a pitch.
With 93 wins in his big league career against 87 losses. He was an all-star in 08. Came up with the Rangers, and then after that all-star season was traded for Josh Hamilton.
Broken bat roller under the glove of Volquez, and he will not have a play. 3-0.
A little good fortune to go along with all these good at bats, and it's a knock for Contreras. Absolutely shattered his bat. Gets the job done.
Three consecutive run scoring singles from Baez, Schwarber, and Contreras. Jason Hayward takes a strike. He contributed 2 hits on opening day. Well, the whole lineup was good.
13 hits. They took 8 walks. Real good approach. A lot of sharply hit balls through the middle and to the opposite side of the field.
Nothing and 2 on Hayward.
And now Volquez just trying to survive the first inning. Here's his 0-2. There's a double play ball. Andrews and Odor. 6-4-3 to get him out of it, but the Cubs put up a three spot for Yu Darvish, who's back in Texas. He'll throw his first pitch of the year next.
Whose idea was this?
Come on.
At some point, a line has to be drawn.
No!
For us, that line is only delivering within 5 minutes of our stores, so your sandwich arrives freaky fresh. It's nothing personal. It's because sandwich.
Mom? Why is the sky doing that?
Get in the house, son.
Now!
We plan on broadcasting from this frequency as long as we're able.
The whole world's waiting for your solution.
Everything's gonna be just fine.
You found its weakness?
I found our strength. And the best part is, we've been carrying it the whole time.
Game, set, match.
I know, right?
So the Rangers will line up 1 through 9, brought to you by Southwest. Shin Soo Chu did not play on opening day. That's very rare for him. Odor, Andrews, who had 3 hits, Mazzara in right hitting cleanup, Gallo, Cabrera, Ronald Guzman at first, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa, the backup catcher, gets a start. Delino DeShields Jr. is in center, batting ninth.
Cubs defensively presented by Fields Auto Group. A little different look, right? Chris Bryant gets a start in left field tonight. He did that 10 times last year, 52 times in his career. He's been a starting left fielder. Albert Almora Jr. made a very nice diving catch in the ball game on opening day. Hayward's won 5 Gold Gloves. Bodie and Baez cover the left side of the infield. Zobrist and Rizzo second, first. Contreras behind the plate. And our Lexus Experience Amazing starting pitcher is the veteran right-hander Yu Darvish. Pretty much a lost season last year. Made just 8 starts, went 1-3 with an ERA of 4.95. It's Yu versus Chu.
Off the inside corner for ball one. And Chu had a 10-year opening day start streak snapped on Thursday, including 5 in a row at Texas. His manager said he needed to get Hunter Pence in there. They're not scheduled to face many lefties over the first 3 weeks or so.
Chu wasn't exactly diplomatic about it, was he?
No,
a lot
he
of grumbling.
And Chris Woodward said, I expected him to be upset, but I can't manage differently because it's opening day. Showing bunt against the shift and takes ball two.
Chu, a high average hitter, typically sees a lot of pitches, takes a lot of walks.
92 of them last year. In his first year as an all-star in his 14th season. There's a strike. 2 balls, 2 strikes. And if you hadn't seen Darvish in spring training, it's simpler. The motion. And had more moving parts in terms of that leg kick. See working out of the stretch exclusively. Swing and a miss, strike three.
Breaking ball. Darvish gets Chu to get things started. That's what he does. among starting pitchers all time with at least 100 major league starts. He has the highest strikeouts per nine inning. And look at that list. First 10, 15 guys on that list, just about all of them are active or have pitched in recent years. The strikeout rate climbing year after year here.
Rougned Odor, the second baseman, grounds one foul near the first base dugout. The Rangers signed Darvish out of Japan for a 6-year deal prior to 2012 after he had been posted. Rangers had the highest bid. It was a sealed offer for the Hokkaido Nippon Ham Fighters. So they got his negotiating rights and paid a reported $51.7 million to just negotiate with him, and they did sign him.
Finished third in the Rookie of the Year balloting his first year in 2012. Four times he's been an all-star. Finished second in Cy Young voting in 2013.
The target. Contreras wanted that pitch in the dirt, but Odor laid off. 1-2.
This gives you a lot of different looks for a power pitcher. You know, normally a guy that throws 95, 96 miles per hour, it's fastball, breaking ball, changeup. He'll throw a slider, a cutter, a curve, a splitter, a changeup. I mean, they're all in there. From start to start, he might not use them all. Over the course of his career, he has.
Yank foul to right. Odor now 25. Not a big guy, but he's got power. 5'11", 195. He's not up there trying to hit singles.
Well, 18 home runs last year, but 30 or more the two previous seasons. He lost time due to injury last season.
Well, how do you take that? 2-2. The answer is probably, if I swing at it, I'm going to miss it.
You're fooled and you just can't pull the trigger. And you hope for the best. One of the downsides of being a strikeout pitcher is you typically work a lot of deep counts. Sometimes that leads to an early exit.
Pretty smooth spring. Did deal with that blister on the ring finger, but it basically didn't miss any time. He struck him out on a fastball.
Contreras sets up over the inside corner. Darvish hits the spot. Odor takes the walk. As in the walk back to the dugout, not the free pass variety.
Elvis Andrus had a pretty good day despite a blowout loss. Now that was with the bat. Tough day on defense, and he took Jason Hayward seed off his left wrist. Said the infield on Thursday played really fast.
Yeah, they put they tore out the infield this winter. Put in new sod, new grass, and it's pretty thin. The infield is playing very fast right now. Maybe some funky hops.
Good breaking ball. Always fun, at least in theory, to face your former team.
Yeah, it looked like Darvish and Andrus were sharing a moment there after that second pitch.
In case you're wondering, Darvish is the all-time leader in strikeouts in this ballpark now with 511.
360 ERA in this ballpark, and this is a tough place to pitch, especially as the weather heats up.
And 3-1. Darvish, long known as a pretty deliberate worker, but even tonight, you notice, and it's subtle, but not taking as much time between pitches. 3-2.
The same one, just running off that outside corner a little bit. See if you can get the chase. Didn't. And Andrus thinking right along with him. And Andrus has never been a real patient hitter either. I think that was actually a good pitch. It didn't work out, but normally you're going to get him to bite.
Mazzara had a ninth inning homer off Mike Montgomery in the opener.
Rangers figured to be better against right-handed pitching. They've got a lot of left-handed bats in their lineup, and most of the power guys swing from the left side. Sudden, it's obviously only the bottom of the first, but this becomes a pretty big at bat with Joey Gallo at 40 home runs on deck.
Strike called. It's 1-1. Cool night, wind is blowing, but not nearly as blustery as it was on Thursday. Javi Baez playing about as deep as you will see him. He is a good 40 feet into the outfield grass. Late.
Boy, was he ever. A lot of movement in that swing. He was late getting started. Home run he hit off Mike Montgomery the other day came on a changeup. So let's see if they decide just to attack him with velocity here.
Andrus took a two out walk. Nobody has put a ball in play after two strikeouts and the free pass. 2-2 on Mazzara. Makes it warmer. He's got his hoodie. You got your ski cap on. You were prepared.
I was lucky.
2-2 on its way, and it's inside.
Had to have the ski cap.
Be on the go here with two outs.
Had to have the ski cap for the ride from home to the airport when we left Chicago for spring training. Otherwise, I wouldn't have it. This is what I was talking about earlier with Darvish. And this, you know, he doesn't pitch to contact. He's trying to punch you out. Patient team can really run up that pitch count.
Payoff pitch driven to left in the corner. Foul. So we'll do it again. When I said it's not, or it doesn't feel nearly as windy tonight as it was on Thursday. Looking down at the players, Anthony Rizzo's pants kind of blousing in the wind. It looks like there are some gusts on the field. You see some debris blowing around on the field as well. Sequel to American Beauty.
Backdoor slider. Let's think it over. The blister that Darvish had is on the inside of his ring finger. That's really a kind of an odd place to develop a blister for a pitcher, and that's why the thinking was it wouldn't be much of an issue, because it doesn't really come into play all that often when you deliver the baseball.
Back to back walks. Hottavy will make a visit. Time now for the TD Ameritrade right call.
Yeah, it's an interesting case, Joey Gallo. Big time power, but a lot of swing and miss too. Lowest average in the season with 40 or more home runs. Adam Dunn tops the list, and then Gallo's done it twice. Gallo will take his walks too. He's just up there flailing away.
Well, this has been a three true outcome inning with a three true outcome guy at the plate. Nothing but strikeouts and walks so far. And then again, Baez will play deep in the hole over on the right. Bodie's got to keep Andrews honest. Here's the pitch. It's low.
Anthony playing strong pull is pretty close to the line at first base, and Contreras loves to throw behind a left-handed hitter. Mazar gets a little loose down there at first. They might take a shot at him.
Darvish ready for a 1-0. Gallo tried to hold, and he was successful.
Gallo doesn't hit it on the ground all that often, but when he does, that's typically where it ends up.
Big cut. 2-1. Well, the Rangers are certainly going to take a chunk out of his night as he nears 30 pitches in the opening inning.
And both walks And again, you probably, if you're Darvish, you had to do it all over again, you'd be a little bit more aggressive with those 3-2 pitches. But they were both pretty good pitches to guys who normally aren't all that patient. And credit Andrus and Mazar with good discipline in laying off those pitches, just moving off the plate.
Cubs got three in the top of the first off Volquez. And this next offer from Darvish will be number 30. And they're loaded. For Astrubal Cabrera, who went hitless in his Ranger debut.
Not a big sample, but pretty good numbers for Cabrera against Darvish. 5 out of 16 with a home run. 23 long balls last year and a .262 batting average.
Cabrera, a switch hitter. Pops one up near our booth. Come on, JD. You had a shot at it.
I don't have enough range. There it is.
You had a shot at that one. That was.
Yeah, just
was catchable.
A little late to the party getting out of my chair here.
Another one our way. Okay, you have to explain.
I just have one here that I play with, and you recovered the one that flew in here, and I was trying to convince the fans that we did magic and turned one into two.
Trying to put away Cabrera, bases loaded. Two down. Ripped foul. Hector Ortiz had to jump out of the way, the Rangers' first base coach. This is something. He's thrown 33 pitches. Not one ball has been put in play.
It's like a little league game with the big kid on the mound. Is either going to walk you or strike you out.
One and two. So has it been a stingy Ranger lineup here these last three batters, or is Darvish missing that badly?
I think it's been a combination. I think when it gets right down to cases, especially the first two walks, it was really good discipline on the 3-2 counts. And again, you know, in hindsight, if you're Darvish, especially with the 3-run lead in the first inning, you'd prefer to be a little bit more aggressive and not get yourself into those situations where you feel like you have to make the perfect pitch.
He went. Strikeout. Strikeout, walk, 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 strikeout. 3-0 after one.
You know that friend who's always there for you? The kind that will take you wherever you need to go, whenever you need to go there? The one who accepts you and all your stuff? That kind of friend who doesn't make a big deal if you change your mind? Southwest is that kind of airline. That's why over 134 million people chose to fly Southwest last year. Because no matter where you're going, it's always better to go with friends.
Run with us on a John Deere X300 series mower. Because seasons change, a true character doesn't.
Wow, you outdone yourself this time.
What are neighbors for?
It's beautiful.
Run with us. Search John Deere X300 for more.
I am the DQ Chicken Strip Basket, and I have gone flavor crazy. Try spicy sweet glazed made with Frank's Red Hot or honey barbecue glazed. Either way, ranch me for maximum flavor craziness, because I'm not fast food. I am fan food.
I'm gonna make the change.
Did I just witness a call to the bullpen?
Nope. Just called the TD Ameritrade trade desk.
Oh, that's great.
For my first call when I gut check a trade.
Always a good move. Yeah, that's why you're the manager. I'll just sit back and co-manage. So what do I do?
Hey, just kind of point around, I'll touch your face, you know. Yeah, like you've done it before, though.
Oh.
Make the right call with the strategy gut check from TD Ameritrade's trade desk.
Tonight, coverage begins at 9 on NBC Sports Chicago.
How about some Xfinity high-speed action? Kept the line moving, didn't they?
Yeah, it was 2-0 fastball that Brian picked on. Schwarber, first pitch swinging, and then good luck. Here's Olkes, couldn't make a play on the broken bat comebacker.
David Bode ducked out of the way, and that breaking ball came back over the plate for a strike. First career opening day, and he got the start on Thursday and had two hits, reached three times, scored twice.
It's a nice adjustment here. Two pitches into the top half of the second inning. Volquez throwing a couple of good breaking balls for strikes. And Cubs were on the fastball, and they weren't chasing the changeup last inning.
And it makes quick work of Bode.
Cubs home opener is just around the corner, and the Cubs are inviting everybody in. Every pitch, every play, every game counts towards a trip to October. Be there at Wrigley Field to experience every moment, beginning with April games. Tickets still available for the opening week, featuring games against the Pirates and the Angels. Get yours today at Cubs.com.
Now Mora hit leadoff. Thursday, he is batting ninth tonight. Get used to it. Joe will tweak that lineup on just about a daily basis. And a 2-0 delivery, and it is low. And Albert draws the walk. That is the fifth walk of this game. Hendrickson, Cole Hamels, David Bode talked about posture. Missing a posture specialist might not love what Ben does as he gets ready to hit. He's got those shoulders up, but it works for him.
You see, he tucks that chin behind that front shoulder, making sure he keeps that shoulder in, doesn't want to pull off the ball. Because over the course of his career has been a pretty good ground ball pitcher. You're always wary of a potential double play ball in this situation. If you try to play hit and run, and you're not going to now 0-2, but he can be a little hard to pin down too, right? You know, normally you like to hit and run against guys who are around the plate and you feel comfortable you're going to put the ball in play against.
One and two the count. Game three in Milwaukee. Brewers have a 4-2 lead over St. Louis in the fifth. Paul Goldschmidt hit three home runs in the Cardinal win last night.
Christian Yelich went deep today. He's homered in each of the first three games for Milwaukee.
He's pretty good. That is a Hudson Woodruff matchup. Sean Moustakas have also gone deep. So Obrist bounces to Guzman. Andrews return dropped. It might be an error on Volquez. I think the throw may have beaten Zobrist.
Volquez is the best glove man. He couldn't handle that little comebacker last inning, and now this throw hits him.
Yeah, I think they would have had him.
I mean, chest high, it's right there for him.
See, that should be an error, but it's not.
Yeah, that's a silly rule that they can't assume a double play.
Well, let's see if the Cubs can take advantage here. And this is the spot in the order a pitcher does not want to give extra outs. Chris Bryant at the plate.
Zobrist isn't going anywhere. I think Volquez is like, well, I have two choices right now. I can go over to first, or I can throw a pitch to Bryant. Let's try first.
So is that really the case sometimes that you're throwing to first just to continue to think and contemplate?
I'm not for me. I have to just step off, but maybe sometimes guys just do it. They're not sure what they
want
to throw.
It's what pitchers do.
Yeah. He's got first. I'm going to go over there now. The running game is pretty much controlled from the dugout now. You know, the slide step, throw over, all those things. But the pitcher still has, if he wants to, he can still throw over there. Kiner Falefa, the catcher, is an interesting case. An infielder for the most part throughout his minor league career, and he was kind of backed up in the Ranger organization. So he said, how about I try catching? And they said, okay, go for it. He'd only caught 33 professional games prior to last year. And then took over as their backup catcher. But he's still very inexperienced. He's athletic, has really good hands. Still trying to master the nuances of the catching position. He's got a great guy to learn from, their lead guy. Yep. Their number one catcher now is the veteran Jeff Mathis, who's one of the better defensive catchers in the game.
Started the first inning rally with a one out double, scored on the Baez single. I saw him wearing these glasses in the late spring training night games. Three and two. Lynn tomorrow at 3 o'clock Chicago time. Zobrist takes off, and Bryant grounds it foul. After this series, the Cubs head to Atlanta. Their only regular season series at SunTrust Park. And next weekend, three against the Milwaukee Brewers. That'll be fun. Actually, the whole week should be pretty interesting against two division winners from last season. He walked him.
I think we have a theme developing here tonight. Because a couple of years ago he had a game where he, like, nine punch outs and eight walks or five innings or something crazy like that.
Now he's got a deal with Rizzo, and Anthony walked his first time.
He might be looking to go early right here. About the team approach to hitting, you just have to have confidence in the guy behind you. Don't get out of your game. Don't start chasing because there's an opportunity to drive in a run. Pitch out of the zone, go ahead and accept your walk and turn it over to the next guy.
The game you're referencing was May 2nd, 2017. And Volquez was on Marlin against the Rays. He went 4 1/3, gave up 3 hits and 3 runs. He walked 8, struck out 9, so he faced 23 batters, and 17 of those batters walked or struck out.
That had to be fun to watch.
And he gave up a home run, so 18 of the 23 had a true outcome. On the ground toward the hole, Volquez has to cover, and
how did he catch that?
Little stumble, but he was able to make the play.
So that's the trick. You got to throw down around his ankles.
So he gets out of it, and that'll go 4-1. 3-0 Cubs early.
Spring is on, so it's time to get started. But first things first, call True Green for a healthy lawn guaranteed. Millions of homeowners like you trust us to give them a lawn they can live on. Start saving today. Get 50% off your first lawn application.
This is your invitation to unforgettable, to unrivaled, to be our guest. We invite you to more than an exceptionally crafted vehicle. We invite you to an exceptionally crafted experience. This is the invitation to Lexus sales event, with generous offers now through March 31st.
Lease the 2019 NX300 all-wheel drive for $389 a month for 36 months.
Experience amazing at your Lexus dealer.
Keep your projects moving with Masterforce FlexPower Brushless Power Tools. Masterforce's growing line of professional cordless tools gives you power, performance, and durability for whatever you're up against. Masterforce brushless motors give you up to 10 times longer motor life, 30% more power, and 1.5 times more runtime over standard power tools. The perfect solution for getting your projects from start to finish. Power, performance, and durability. Masterforce. Available at Menards.
Hey, the Cubs offer baseball summer camps presented by ATI Physical Therapy and Ideal Industries. Sluggers 5 to 13 can suit up in Cubs gear and get top-notch baseball instruction. Select camps include a current Cubs player and a VIP tour of Wrigley Field. New this year,
our overnight camps, which include a 5-day, 4-night experience to live like a Cubs player. Enroll now at any of the 9 Chicagoland locations at cubs.com/kids.
There's a kid. Ready to play a little ball. So, how do you get over this strikeout walk program that he's got going? He's just trying to drive that fastball down around the knees a little bit, more of a put in play kind of pitch.
Swing and a miss. Guzman 0 for 3 on Thursday.
Guzman's just 24 years old. Most of these guys in this Ranger lineup, 24, 25, mid-20s guys. 2-3 years of experience in the big leagues.
He debuted in the majors last year.
Try 16 home runs, 387 at-bats. He's very good defensively down there at first. Another full count.
Had quite a night on August 10th of last year. First major league rookie ever to hit 3 homers in a game against the Yankees. Did it in front of a bunch of family and friends in the Bronx, including his little league coach. And at 23, he was the youngest player to hit 3 homers at one of the Yankee stadiums since Mickey Mantle in 1955.
That Mantle fella sure could play.
And a leadoff walk to Guzman. Rocket Mortgage, do more to win.
The resume for Darvish as a Ranger, 52-39 with a 342. 4 times he made the All-Star team. Give himself a little pep talk right now.
There's Kiner Falefa. See that nameplate on his back. It's a nice semicircle.
He is from Hawaii.
Wonder if he could request Kiner on the top and then Falefa under the number. That'd be kind of neat.
Mm-hmm, I like that.
One half of the first hyphenated battery in major league history caught Austin Bibbins Dirks.